Good morning. Fair, I'll go for a little walk here. I'm just parked right over there. Coming up this steep hill. Hey Tim, why'd you get stuck? Yeah, you can see you were digging the whole way. It just...
Well, that was really successful.
Not having that pin.
Yeah, I have the same pin on the front. The Peterbilt I had before didn't, so that's nice.
So I'll get rolling a little bit.
Oh, nice.
I'm gonna get up out of the way. Cat is spinning its tracks there to get going. So once he's pulled all the way up, they're gonna unload him at the top, and then the cat will come back down and pull me up. They're doing some road building.
All right, they're unloading Tim up there, and I'm 90% sure I'm gonna be stuck here. Manual. Let's go backwards a little bit. That's where he started spinning, right where I'm parked. First gear, super low, low end gear, and just give her, not do any shifting. Whatever we get, we get. You know what? I really think we can do that in higher gear. Trying that again. Breaking branches with my mirrors. That's okay. I'm gonna try it in first gear, not in low. Like I said, 90% sure that's what's gonna happen. pickup to move out of the way. So the other two trucks are apparently staged at the bottom where the pavement ends. Go in a gear here. Engine brakes on medium. Woo! Starting to slide sideways. Gotta go a little quicker than that. This is one of those, if you don't go quick enough, you're going to jackknife because the trailer is going to pass you. Whew! That is definitely a steep hill. Well, this is fun. Nothing like going out in the backcountry on logging roads with heavy loads. Smokestack is rubbing lots of trees here. Mirrors keep rubbing trees as well on the way up anyway. Let's hope we don't take out the rear facing camera. Yeah, it was drizzling a little bit first thing in the morning, but now it's really nice. Really got to watch the trailer around these corners to make sure I don't let it go down the hill. I'm empty, so if it does slide down, I just hit the gas and it'll pull right out. But on a loaded, you're in a lot of trouble. All right, this little bridge. Definitely trimming the trees back. The amount of branches I've taken down is crazy. He goes, it's been good, but because it rained, all the branches are hanging down low and heavy. Look at all the leaves on the ground. It feels like it's fall. This the highway. No, it's still gravel here, right? sure nobody's coming down that roadway. Don't see anyone. Man, I hope we get more of these contracts. Last couple of weeks have been a couple of these unique ones. Definitely my favorite. Definitely adds a challenge. I don't know if you guys can hear all the scrapes, but I'm getting some good pinstripping on this truck. Especially the top of the bunk. Pretty rough. I know you guys can't see all the potholes. I know watching from Itchy Boots, she's always complaining all the potholes, watching in the video, and like, it doesn't look like that. It's all that bumpy. And it is always much, much bumpier than it looks like on video. Especially since the stabilization on these cameras is so good. How many cars are down here? Maybe they're going fishing in the parks and stuff. I don't know. Gotta hit the brakes. She's bumpy. I guess I never said where I was. So we are up on a logging road. I don't know, probably 12, 13 miles east of Rockport.
it's 8:55 a.m. right now. And it's 14 degrees Celsius out. I had the bunk heat on last night. Wompity womp. There's a rest area just down the road. Other driver in front of me, he's gonna pull in there if he needs his paperwork printed out, because he doesn't have a printer in his truck since he came back to work. He was off of work for quite a while due to the injury, broken leg. I see all three drivers are all, four of us are here now. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's mine.
How old?
I've never seen that before. I just thought it just popped out. Yeah, just popped out.
Oh, interesting.
All right.
Good luck, mate.
Yep, good luck.
I got Brian on mine.
Yeah, there's...
And Steve.
I attempted without chaining up. I'm like, I'll just back up a bit and take some speed. No.
How far did you get?
About 5 feet further than you did.
Oh!
And spun right out.
Did like, you chain up or they just...
No, no, they pull you up with a cat.
Yeah, much quicker.
A small little cat. You'll be spinning the tires while they're pulling you up, yeah. But yeah.
Good for you.
No, it was good.
Help anyway.
Yeah, that was fun. I'll do these anytime. They're fun.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Okay, I'll see you out there once.
Yeah, have a good day.
You too.
That guy's got 80-foot beams. Good luck.
Yeah, he had a flat tire, so he's got one big long beam on his. Whatever. Alright, have a good one.
You too. Have yourself a good day. Go.
almost back to civilization. Sorry?
Right way.
Yep, you're signaling the right way, and then immediate left right after the bridge.
Oh yeah, I remember.
Cascade River Road. Okay, so yeah, I'm headed up to Delta to pick up a partial load there, and then to Abbotsford to pick up another partial load. I believe they're going to Nelson and somewhere. I haven't had a time to take a close look at it, but a one-lane bridge, and then we pull onto Highway 20. And I'll take Highway 20 all the way to I-5, but he is going to turn on Highway 9 northbound to Sumas Huntington Crossing. See if two of us can get through here in one light. Okay, I'm past the white line. We're going if it turns or not. Looks like it used to be a two-lane bridge looking at the lines, but they must have had too many collisions on this bridge. You just can't have a big rig and a car passing each other on a bridge this narrow. You could have two cars, no problem, but I'm just going to keep going directly west, which means leaving Highway 20 and Cedro Woolley. Sure, I said it wrong last time and you guys corrected me, and I think I'm trying to change it now, but I'm not 100% sure. Cedro Woolley. And if I'm wrong, we'll try to get it right next time. But we won't make it that far on this video. We've spent way too much time in the forest. Our batteries will be dead before we get to Cedro Woolley. Nope. I've lost it. I'm not even trying anymore. Maybe I should. Cedro Woolley. Okay, going with that. But yeah, our batteries will be dead long before I get there, because I was shooting little clips of him getting towed up and stuff like that. Well, you guys saw at the beginning of the video. You saw what I shot. Hopefully I could use all of it. No microphone on any of that, so hopefully I'm audible. If not, I'm sorry, I just didn't have time. It's like, stuff is going on, grab a camera and go. The best camera setup is the one I have right now, and that's all I got right now. Let's do it. Such a beautiful drive. Highway 20 has been closed due to wildfires. It sounds like they're going to be planning on opening it, maybe even today. But as of yesterday, it was still closed. And of course, I shot this 2 weeks ago, so. Just remember, forest fire season, always check the roads before driving anywhere. Beautiful and fun and relaxing drive. Rockport Meats. I think the town is still ahead of us, but good luck making a map for this. Hadn't thought of that. I never like following someone. Because everybody always has a little bit different style of driving, but he's driving at decent speed. He's doing good. Still don't like following someone, even though he's doing good. Oh, there's another driver. I didn't know there was more. Car behind me signaling as if they're gonna pass, but they're not passing. Gonna pass me or not? Slowing down so they can pass me. I also shot a Sleep with a Trucker video yesterday from Sumas all the way to about here somewhere. Driving down Highway 9. So check out that video. It should be coming out on Sleep with a Trucker in a next week or so. Really a longer video, but I really want to get to Rockport. I know the battery's flashing there, but I think we're almost there. I think the junction up ahead is Rockport. There's not much to see from the highway. The town's kind of off the road and in the thick trees, so definitely not much to see. Oh yeah, entering Rockport. Cool. So Rockport's actually kind of off to the left-hand side here. Yeah, down these little roads to the left. There's a small town down there. Deceivingly, it doesn't look like there's a town there at all, but there is. It's a nice small little town down there. Alright, we're going to call it a day there. I had fun on this one. This was so much fun. I didn't have much to say, but I had fun on this one. So head up north, be back in Canada again. Probably next, tomorrow's video probably will be somewhere along Highway 3. See how far I get today. Maybe we'll be in the Kootenays. Yeah, we'll probably be in the Kootenays for tomorrow's video. Little Abbotsford, head over toward Nelson, and we'll shoot a video somewhere down that way. For now, I'm out of here. See you guys tomorrow. You guys absolutely rock.